MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's game two of the ALDS between the Minnesota Twins and the Houston Astros. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. I'm joined by Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Danny, an important ballgame coming up here in Game 2.
Yeah, this is just a five-game series, so getting that first win under you is great. The most important game of a series, though, is the next one you're about to play. So treating this game like it's absolutely critical is a good way not to get too comfortable with your lead.
All right. The stage is set. The starters get their final tosses in out in the bullpen, and we've got a good one in store for you, folks. Play-by-play is coming up next. Lance McCullers is on the mound for Game 2. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, Matt, Lance McCullers might have the best right-handed breaking ball in the game of baseball. Has the kind of hard slider that he could throw four or five times in a row and still get swings and misses. Fastball too, 93 to 95 miles an hour, wipeout, and I mean wipeout breaking ball. His changeup has gotten better every year. If he's throwing strikes early, he's a nightmare on hitters.
In there, 1-2 now.
1-2.
Into the windup and the pitch. Temperature starting to drop as the sun goes down. 56 degrees here at first pitch. Two pitch is fouled away. Here's the pitch. A swinging bunt up the third baseline. The 2-2 one more time. Popped him up. Bregman over to his right. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. One down with the bases empty, and next to hit will be Luis Arraez. Yeehaw! 2-1 pitch is a knuckle curve taken for called strike two. And we're just underway from Truist Park. Grounded to third. Bregman gloves it. And there's out number two. Third baseman Josh Donaldson. Past meetings against Lance McCullers. He's gone 2-for-5. And he pulled up in time, but it's a called strike two.
That's a great sinker right there. These batters are going to have to bear down, because if he's got that good pitch working, it's going to be a long game. They might have to sit off speed.
2-2. Sent out to straightaway center field. Long run for the center fielder. Around first, he's digging for second. And now that'll hop over the wall. So he'll be at second here with two away on a ground rule double.
There's a deep fly ball. Doesn't quite get out of the ballpark, but it hits in the right spot as it bounces off that hard warning track and over the wall for a ground rule double. Not sure if he had triple on his mind, but I doubt he'll complain too much about getting to coast into second base.
Swinging a ball hit on the ground. From the stretch, the 1-2. Swing as he stays alive as this is fouled back right off the catcher's arm. 1-2, here it is. In the dirt here. but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Two and two. Here it is. Hit on the ground out to short. Fielded cleanly. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. Two out double, left stranded. Game two coverage rolls on after this. Jay Happ will be on the bump for game two of the series. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, thanks, Matt. Jay Happ, big, tall guy, about 6'4", 215 pounds. It's really put things together. Not overpowering, but pinpoint control. Reminds me a lot of former AL Cy Young Award winner Cliff Lee. Control with really good stuff, good fastball, good changeup, and his curveball is getting a lot better.
And he takes ball four. So the leadoff man is on here in the home half of the first in a scoreless ball game.
Batting second, the third baseman, Alex.
And that'll bring up Alex Bregman. In past meetings with Jay Happ, batting at an even 400. He also has one home run. 1-1 pitch is a sinker taken for a strike, one and two. Happ has hurled more than 1,700 innings in the majors during his career and has an ERA just under four, a respectable number that he'd like to improve upon in this one. Altuve aboard here at first with nobody out. Oh, and ouch, that one drilled him. Gets him, so they are able to get an out on an unusual play. And hopefully the pitcher's okay. And this has to be a big concern here. This ball came back and got him right in the pitching aisle, and that is something you just never want to see. You can see him trying to work this one off, and from all appearances, I think they're going to let him continue, so that at least is a good sign. One out, runner at first, and that brings in the left-handed hitting outfielder, Michael Brantley. The 1-1 home. This one's down to third. The second for one, on to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. They'll move on to the second now at Truist Park with no score. And now here is Miguel Sano, as it'll be 5, 6, and 7 due up to kick off the second inning. The 1-1. Drives it out to deep right center field. Tucker moves to his right and puts this one away in the alley for out number one.
That is good. The left fielder, number 30, Kyle Garlick.
Up next for Minnesota, Kyle Garlick. Off speed ball. Pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
Three balls, one strike.
And he misses ball four.
Pitcher's wondering how he didn't get that call. Busted him inside on a 3-1 count. The ump thought it was just a tad off the plate. Tough to get the benefit of the doubt from the umpire when you fall behind in a count like that, though.
So a runner at first with one out now, and that'll bring up the speedy outfielder Byron Buxton. Here now the 2-2. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. Another 2-2 offering.
Ball.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
Ball Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for out number two. And so with two away now, let's give you another look at our playoff bracket as you see what could lie ahead for the winner in this series. Now at the plate here is Ryan Jeffers. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. Hit hard up the middle, and that finds its way through for a base hit.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dad. Sent it back right where it came from.
Standing in now, Andrelton Simmons. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now.
I don't think he can afford another base runner here, so whatever pitch he feels best about, whichever one he feels most comfortable with, that's the one I expect him to turn to.
And whoa, awfully close, but it's ball four according to Woody Keller.
Looked like he might have gotten squeezed a little bit right there, and you know he's talking to himself in his head about it. That kind of stuff goes both ways, though. Hitters get their fair share of crummy calls going against them, too.
At the plate now, Max Kepler. One and two now as that one's fouled off.
He's gone to the well with that pitch three times in a row. I'm interested to see if he changes it up right here.
Again, he sends it out of play. Garlick, the runner at third. Jeffers over at second. Simmons on at first with two down. Rolled slowly to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself. And a great job of pitching out of the bases loaded situation as the side is retired. A couple of walks, but no damage. Back with more postseason baseball in game two after this. Half of the second set to go, and the former number one overall pick and American League Rookie of the Year, Carlos Correa, bats next. Takes this the other way to right, and a base hit, so early trouble to lead off the inning. Into the box now, Yordan Alvarez. Three and two now. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. The next 3-2. Popped him up. Jeffers has a play. And that's the first out of the inning.
Batting fifth, the first baseman, Yulieski. Very well.
Striding in for Houston, Yuli Gurriel. A 1-1 is in there for the second strike.
Can't come out of his game plan right here. He knows he's a known sinker baller. I know it was a four-seamer right there, but get back to that two-seam. It's what his MO is.
Working for the punch out and the offering. Reached for and popped into the air back behind second. Arias backs up and takes care of it. Two away. So a runner at first with two away. And in to hit next will be the outfielder Kyle Tucker. Bottom of the second here with no score. Fouled off. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. One left for Houston. He'll move to the third with no score. So now here is Luis Arias. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Cut fastball that time, but he doesn't bite, and now it's 3-1.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Tried to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. And he lays off their ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin inning number three.
Well, he's really laboring in the early going here. That's his third walk of the game already. We'll see if he can get it together, or if this is just one of those days where he's going to have to grind his way through this start.
Josh Donaldson digging in now. It was a double for him in his first turn at the plate. Arias gets his lead at first, nobody out. Breaking ball called just a bit low.
Got to find a way to get back in the zone. I know you're in danger of losing both to walks, but certainly don't miss over the heart of the plate and have this guy gap one, or even worse, hit a two-run homer.
And boy, that misses as well. It's back-to-back walks to start out the inning.
And that's two free passes in the third inning alone, so you have to wonder if maybe it's something mechanical or if it's just psychological. Got to get back on track here.
Striding forward now is the DH, Nelson Cruz. He bounced out last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll two.
Ball taken there. 2-1 now. First and second here with nobody out. Two balls and two strikes now.
Hey, boys, you talking about getting your ace swing off right here? That's what it looks like. A guy with massive power letting it eat.
Here now the 2-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him.
Up next to the plate.
So the big bat of Miguel Sano digs in next. Flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Ready to deliver the 1-2. And struck him out.
Big strikeout for the second out there, but he's not out of it yet. We'll see if he can feed off that cake, wiggle out of the jam, and keep this game tied.
The next twin up, Kyle Garlick, worked a walk his first time up. Here's the 1-1. Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone.
He's already walked two in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
Out in front there as this one's pulled off to the left side.
Man, he wants that swing back. He'll be thinking about that all night. He crushed that ball. He just needs to stay back a little longer.
Still 2-2. This one misses, and that'll fill the count here. 3-2 with two away.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Ready with the payoff pitch. Weak grounder back to the mound. On to first, and the Twins are turned away here as the side is retired. So they let him off the hook here by scoring no runs despite the two walks. We'll head now to the home half of inning number three, and we are tied 0-0. Bottom of the third now, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Miles Straw. Hit out towards second. And that's a base hit, so the pressure's on to open up the inning.
Pitcher executed his pitch. Good sinker down and in. Not got enough. The hitter to beat it into the ground. Sometimes there's nothing you can do about it as a pitcher.
And now, Martin Maldonado. And this runs inside, and that looked like it got him pretty good.
Well, this home crowd didn't like this guy in the mound before, but now they really don't like him. He's gotten the baseball all worked up by hitting one of their best hitters early on in this game. And you can bet he's really going to hear it if he comes around to score.
So now to the plate, Jose Altuve. High and deep down the left field line. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Buxton is in retreat as he pulls it in for the first out. And he'll indeed move up 90 feet, putting runners at the corners now with one away.
Good read there at second base to know he could make it to third on the flyout. Now he's only 90 feet away with one out.
Up next, Alex Bregman, reached by way of a fielder's choice his first time around. Here it is.
Ball.
Couldn't be a whole lot better situation to hit it now. 3-1, 2-on. He's got to be thinking he's going to get a pitch he can drive right here.
And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
That's a big no-no. He obviously had to work carefully with two men on, but he did not want to walk him to load the bases. Now he's really got his work cut out for him. We'll see how he fares here.
Bases are loaded here with one away. And Michael Brantley settles in to hit at the plate. Now the 2-1 pitch. And this is on the ground to short. Could be two. There's one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, this side is retired. Just what the doctor ordered. He gets the double play to get him out of the inning. Game two coverage rolls on after this. Matt Vasgersian, Mark DeRosa, and Dan Plesac back with you as Byron Buxton readies to lead off the inning. Now the 1-1 pitch. There's a changeup that drops below the knees for a ball. Well, if you love pitching and defense, this has been a game for you. Are you happy with that, Dan?
I think this continues for a while, Matt. Both of these pitchers are throwing very well, throwing strikes, having good command of their off-speed pitches. This is going to be one of those low-scoring affairs.
Buxton ahead in the count, 3-1. Into the corner and slicing foul. Now the payoff pitch home. And here's a ball hit in the air. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. He'll try it again, 3-2. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
Well, in a scoreless game, you want to do anything you can to jumpstart your offense. With the speed of this guy on first, don't be surprised if he gets the green light here.
So now to the plate, Ryan Jeffers. He singled in his first AB. Here comes the 1-1.
Sometimes you got to be aggressive offensively, but sometimes you just let the pitcher dig his own grave. Patience and discipline seem to be the way to go right here.
Both teams with just two hits apiece thus far. And it's fouled away. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. So a full count now.
Gotta believe that runner from first is gonna be in motion, especially in this situation. As an offensive player, just hit something hard because those defenders are gonna be moving.
Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Buxton on at first, nobody out. And he misses again, ball four, and his control is really letting him down now.
Well, they've struggled offensively in this one so far, but after that walk, they've got runners at first and second and look ready to make a little noise. Just need a big hit now.
In now is Andrelton Simmons, worked a walk in his first plate appearance. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. A ball and two strikes, here's the pitch. And this one's in the dirt. And a nice job to keep the runners at bay as the count moves to 2-2. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. And the sinking fastball called strike three, and that's out number one.
Well, I'm glad we get another look at that beauty of a pitch right there. You can't spot a sinker in a better location because even if you do get the bat on the ball, there's not a whole lot you can do with that. Textbook sinker.
Here comes the Astros skipper up out of the Houston dugout, and a change is forthcoming as that's going to do it for his starter here this evening. So he'll depart here, and I don't know if maybe there's something wrong with him physically, but it seems a very quick hook as he's gone after not allowing a single run. Ryan Stanek takes the mound to try to get out of this mess. There are two on with only one away.
Number 45, Ron Stanek.
Into the box, Max Kepler. A ball and two strikes.
Hey guys, that fastball just registered 97 miles an hour. On a night like tonight, where it's super cold out, if you don't get to head to that baseball right there and you get jammed, it's almost like getting stung by a pack of wasps.
And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play. Next, it'll be Luis Arraez. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Ready with the 2-1. Fouled away. The 2-2 pitch. A full count, three balls and two strikes.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
Hit on the ground down the first baseline. Gurriel brings it in, and the inning will end as they're unable to cash in with two outs. Twins strand a pair. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. So here's the cleanup hitter, Carlos Correa, a base hit in his first trip.
The old adage, pitching and defense have been stellar so far. They've certainly kept both offenses in check.
And he fouls this one off. Here's another 1-2. Here's a pop-up now. Sano is there for it. One down. That'll bring up Yordan Alvarez. 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
Alvarez.
The 2-1 home. Doesn't hit the target. It's ball three.
We all know this guy is a great hitter. In a 3-1 count, this is just what he's looking for. He loves to hit when the count's in his favor like this.
Full count, 3-2.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here. Shoot for the corner, and if you miss and you walk him, so what? That's better than him putting one in the seats.
Chopped on the ground over to first. He's got it. And he'll step on first himself for the out.
Now back. The first base.
Next up for the Astros, Yuli Gurriel flew out in his only at bat so far. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
He got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the inning. 1-2-3 go the Astros. Through four, still tied, nothing. Welcome back to Truist Park just outside Atlanta as we send it down to check in with Heidi.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Twins to discuss his thoughts on Minnesota's lineup so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. He said he's really proud of the 6 walks they've earned so far. And while a lot of that falls on the opposing pitching, he appreciates his hitters' willingness to take what's being given to them. Sometimes that can be easier said than done, though.
Thank you, Heidi. Now at the plate is Josh Donaldson. Takes that one a little bit low. 3 balls and a strike now.
They know the threat this guy poses at the plate. I know it's a 3-1 in this situation right here, but I cannot believe for the life of me this pitcher is going to come anywhere near the middle of the zone.
Out of the stretch, here's his 3-1 home. High in the air down the right field line. He's around first, heading for two. And now this will get over the wall down the line out there for a ground rule double.
Hey, this is what every hitting coach teaches when you start playing baseball. Don't try to do more than you can. Hit the ball where it's pitched. And he does a great job right there as he pushes it down the line nicely. And it bounces over for a ground rule double.
Stepping in now, Nelson Cruz.
Outside.
Now a good slider that doesn't quite catch the zone. It's 2-1 now. Now the Astros are going to get a left-hander up and cranking out in the bullpen. And a 2-1 slider is looked at for a called strike two. Donaldson leads off second with nobody out. And this is lined hard to deep left. Brenton is there and he makes the catch for the out. And as a result of that errant throw back in, he'll advance 90 feet here and move up from second to third.
Well, he hit that ball pretty well, but the only problem was that he pulled off it just a bit. The location was a little on the outer half, so he would have hit it even better if he would have stayed through the middle of the field with it.
At the plate, Miguel Sano. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. No score here, but a potential run is 90 feet away with one gone. And he rolls over this one foul. We'll do it once more. 3-2. Another full count pitch home.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
Payoff pitch one more time. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Full count still.
Six fouls in a row. This is turning into one of those epic at-bats. Who's going to blink first? Is the pitcher going to continue to attack the zone? Or is the hitter going to come outside it?
And, whoa, awfully close, but it's ball four, according to Woody Keller.
And with first base open, the last thing he wanted to do was give him something to hit in the heart of the zone. So, no harm done. Force out anywhere now.
Next to dig in, Kyle Garlick. His prior history versus this arm. Just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. A swing and a high drive to right center field. But that'll stay in the park as it's off the wall. The relay throw. Throw won't get him.
Yeah, when that left his bat, I thought it was out of here for a three-run shot. But to his credit, he didn't hesitate or break into that home run trot. He busted it out of the box and was thinking triple all the way. Well done.
Now, Byron Buxton can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Working for the punch out and the offering. He got him, and it'll probably take a base hit now to get that runner across from third. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. Do you think you can drive it? But it's really hard to get on top of that good, high, hard fastball.
And strike three called as he says, you got to be kidding me, with the side retired. So it's two runs on two hits, no errors, and a runner left. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Twins two and the Astros nothing. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. During the commercial break, I discussed the Astros offense with Houston's manager. And one thing he mentioned to me was the lack of discipline he's seeing out of their at-bats right now. He said their pitch selection has been the main reason for their struggles today, as far too often they've been swinging at pitches outside the strike zone. That's leading to a lot of soft contact and easy outs. So the focus going forward is on shrinking the zone and forcing the opposing pitching to throw more strikes.
Thank you, Heidi. Ready with the 1-1 pitch.
Ball. Pitcher wants to have a quick inning right here. Capitalize on the momentum his batters have.
Now the 2-1 pitch.
Ball three.
Hey, throwing the ball great up until this point. Don't want to allow a leadoff walk. Needs to just focus in on his mechanics right here.
And the count will be full. Now the payoff pitch home. Hangs on him a bit that time as it's belted out toward deep center field. And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. So it's a solo shot to dead center, his second home run of the series. And the Astros are on the board. It's now a 2-1 ball game.
Listen, there's an old adage in baseball that solo home runs won't kill you. This is one of the top hitters in that lineup. So a home run, a solo home run right here, it's not the end of the world.
At the plate now, Miles Straw. A little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
Maldonado.
So now to the plate, Martin Maldonado. Maldonado behind the ball and two strikes.
Take a step back right here. After three fastballs in a row, there is no chance he throws you a fourth.
One run on three hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Grounded up the first baseline. Reined in. And a step on first for the out. Three unassisted.
Now back. Second baseman.
Here's the second baseman, Jose Altuve.
Altuve.
Popped up. Sano in foul ground. And that's the third out. Astros claw back a bit on this solo home run. Through five innings, it's the Twins 2 and the Astros 1. Blake Taylor takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Number 62. What?
Top half of the sixth about to get started. And standing in, one of the best two-strike hitters in baseball, Andrelton Simmons. Now the pitch. A ball and two strikes now.
He's going to have to set his sights a little lower right there. That pitch was able to get by him. His swing was just a little under that.
Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and it backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
Into the box now, Max Kepler. That fastball's too much for him there, 1-2. And now a left-hander will start to get ready in the bullpen. The 1-2. Not surprisingly here, this is on the ground to the right side. And he'll step on first himself for the out. That'll bring up Luis Arraez. 0 for 2 for him to this point. Here comes the 1-2. Line toward right center. That gets down, and the inning continues. So the two-out hit extends things for Josh Donaldson next.
Boy, just when you're looking for one of those shutdown innings, you get two quick outs, D-roll, then give up a two-out base hit to extend the inning.
Yeah, you show me a big league ball player that's going to give away an A-B, no chance. Everybody's in there grinding every at-bat, every plate appearance. Nice job, maybe a little two-out lightning starting.
Arraez is off of first with two away. All even now, 2-2. Has a look, now the pitch.
Ball.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Fouled off. Payoff pitch one more time, and it's fouled away. And awful close, but it's ball four, according to Woody Keller.
Man, as a pitcher, I can tell you that is so frustrating. He's got two outs, and he wants to get that third out as quickly and painlessly as possible, but that hitter makes him work his tail off, and he still loses him.
The number four Minnesota hitter, Nelson Cruz. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Here's the payoff pitch. Fouled away. Low scoring game thus far. 2-1 here in the sixth. Here's a shot to left field and deep. Look at this. And gone up into the second deck. So a three-run blast to straightaway left, his second home run of the series, and it's suddenly a 5-1 ball game.
Yeah, he is kicking himself right now. He worked his tail off to get out of that jam and was one strike away from getting there, and then, boom, all that work goes to waste. From zero damage to a three-run homer in the blink of an eye.
Now Brooks Raley, a southpaw standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen. Standing in now, Miguel Sano. Slider misses, and he's in danger of losing him here, 3-1. Can't keep that one fair, and now the count's full. Three runs already home here. Count remains full. The next 3-2. And he misses ball four. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces. So that's the second walk he's worked in this one.
Yeah, that seems to be a popular approach when this guy steps in. He can really hurt you with one swing. So I think the idea is mostly not to let this one guy beat you, Matt.
Now in the box, Kyle Garlick. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Here comes the 1-2.
Ball.
Swing and a hard liner to center field. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. But the Twins do strike for three, all coming on this 3-run home run. Bottom of the sixth is straight ahead. It's the Twins 5 and the Astros 1. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and set to go is the third baseman, Alex Bregman. The 1-1 home. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Garlick is in his tracks now. One gone.
The left fielder, number 23.
One away for the Astros Michael here in the sixth. And that Brantley brings in the left-handed hitting outfielder, Michael Brantley. Two and two.
He's going to step out of the box, adjust his bat and gloves, and pray he gets the exact same pitch as that one. Because if it comes again, we like to refer to that one in the biz as a cement mixer.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Buxton is there, two gone.
No batter, number one.
Here's Carlos Correa now. He's 1-for-2 in the ballgame.
Correa.
We're in the sixth inning now, a 5-1 ballgame. Fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul.
Hey, this guy's got to be pretty proud of what he's done so far. It's never easy to pitch on the road, but to have this kind of outing in a ballpark that is notoriously known as being hitter-friendly, it's been a treat to watch.
Here comes the 1-2. Got him off balance there as he reaches for one and grounds it to second. They'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. Astros go down 1-2-3. They're down 5-1.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention.
New pitcher coming on now as we get a look at the side armor, Joe Smith.
Number 38.
So now into the box is Byron Buxton. He went down on strikes in his last at bat.
Yeah, he's got to put that one behind him, especially with runners in scoring position. Those punch outs will stick with you a little longer.
Can't find the zone there, and it's 3-1. Take there as they'll have a leadoff man aboard to start the seventh. It's ball four.
That is not the way he wanted to start off this half inning. It's one thing to walk the leadoff hitter, but it's even more painful when the leadoff hitter is an absolute burner and he can really wreak some havoc on the bases.
Next up is Ryan Jeffers, a hit and two at bats for him at this point in the ballgame. The 1-1.
Ha!
Wow, I'm shocked the hitter took it right there. That's a well-executed pitch down in the zone to try and get that double play.
Ready to deliver the 1-2. Got him on the good slider there. Swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight.
That's just a great pitch, both on the call from the catcher and the execution. If he hits it, there's a good chance it turns into a double play ball, but it's also a spot that's going to get a lot of whiffs, too. That's excellent pitching.
In in now, Andrelton Simmons. And he fouls this one off. Now a move over to first.
He's safe.
And he just manages to get his hand in. Buxton leads off first with one away. Hit out towards second. And that gets through for a one-out base hit. And that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now.
Hey, you know what? Right there, he executed a pitch. He can't worry about where it's going. He just wants to put it on the ground right there, give his defense a chance to work, and it found the hole, period, the end.
Into the box, Max Kepler. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. They're going to extend their lead as the runner scores from. It's 6-1. That was pretty obvious in live action that ball was hit hard. And after analyzing it with our show track technology, we see that our eyes did not deceive us. 114 miles an hour was the exit velo. An impressive swing of the bat. Steve Cishek comes on to pitch here with one man gone in the top of the seventh.
Number 31, Steve Cishek.
Plate now, Luis Arias. This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2. Six runs, eight hits, and no errors in the ballgame for Minnesota. Lifts it into the air to shallow center. And a long run, but he gets there, and that's good range in the outfield as there are two gone. So stepping in is Josh Donaldson. Two hits and two trips for him thus far. The 1-1 home is taken for ball two.
He's got a couple of pitches to deal with right here, but he's starting to lose command of his pitches. It might be time to take a step back and try to refocus on making some good pitches.
The 2-1. Two down, runners at first and second. And, oh, this one's by him to the backstop. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on. Popped him up. Gurriel has it, and the side is retired. Twins forced to settle for one. Seventh inning stretch time here at the ballpark. Twins are out in front, 6-1. Last half of the seventh here, and that'll bring up Yordan Alvarez. One home. Ball. To two balls and two strikes now.
Right guy, right spot. This is one of the better hitters in their lineup. Just the guy they want to see coming up now to get this inning going.
Here's a fly ball. Well hit. Kepler looks up. Gone! Shot here to straightaway right field. His second home run of the series as the lead is cut to four. It's 6-2 now.
Normally this matchup is the last thing you want to see left on left, but he kept his front shoulder square, stayed in that at bat, and absolutely demolished that baseball.
Now here Here comes the Twins manager on his way to the mound. And that will bring an end to the appearance by Jay Happ. Tired a bit as he reached the seventh, but he's got a shot at the victory if his bullpen can help him out. Cody Stashak comes on now, and he'll take over with nobody out in inning number seven.
Cody Stashak.
At the plate, Yuli Gurriel. And that one yanked just foul. Base is empty here with nobody out. This is in the air out to right field. Kepler is camped under this one, and he puts it away for the first down. Next to stand in is Kyle Tucker. One run in and one gone so far this inning. Foul off. One out, nobody on. Ball two.
Playing two balls, two strikes.
Full count now, 3-2. Miles Straw will be next. Payoff pitch on its way. Count still full, 3-2. Another payoff pitch. Pulled toward right center field. Buxton will range to his left and put it away. Two down.
Now batting.
And now in the box, Miles Straw, a hit in two tries so far. Bases are empty here with two men out.
Outside.
And this ball runs away for ball two. 2-1. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Swing and a flare hit toward right. In comes Kepler. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. We'll march on to the eighth. Now a 6-2 ball game. Pedro Baez has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 52, Pedro Baez.
And that'll bring up the big stick of Nelson Cruz. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day.
A little bit of a unique home run on that last one. A changeup in off the plate that he pulled for a home run. Not a real good idea to throw that changeup on the inner half of the plate. More executed, well-executed changeups are more down and away.
Can't connect there. It's 2-2. Here it comes. Hard liner, but picked up on a hop. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. Here's Miguel Sano. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. Bases are empty, one man out. A two-ball, one-strike count to the Twins' first baseman. And it misses. 3-1 now. Now the Astros have somebody up in the bullpen as a right-hander has started to warm up out there. just got a piece of that one. Perhaps shortening up now will get the ball in play. He's ready. Now the payoff pitch.
Ball four,
and he takes
outside.
Ball take four again. And they clearly just don't want any part of him in this one.
The batter, the left fielder, Kyle.
Next to hit, Kyle Garland. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here.
Yeah, Matty, but as he walks to the plate right here, he feels good building off that last AB. He hit that ball on the screws.
Ball, outside, no. 2-1.
Two balls, one strike.
And it's fouled away. High ball three. Byron Buxton will be next. Sano, base runner at first with one out. Hit the other way out toward right field. Tucker waits on it, and that's the second out of the inning. Next, it'll be Byron Buxton. He started out the evening 0 for 2 so far. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
No.
In the air down the right field line, and no one will track it down. Fouled away. Seventh pitch of the at bat coming up. Another one sent foul. Ready with another 2-2.
Ball.
Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Now the payoff pitch home. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Strong is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Twins wind up stranding one. They lead it 6-2. Hansel Robles is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 57, Hansel.
Now at the plate, Martin Maldonado. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
It's becoming more and more common in today's game to see relievers like this that can run it up there close to 100 miles per hour. But it's so fun to watch it. He blew it right by him there.
The 1-2 pitch. They try to come in with the fastball, but it's too far in, and it's even at 2-2. Now the Twins are going to get a lefty up and throwing in the bullpen. They really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
Boy, there's nothing like seeing a good power pitcher that has a good fastball. And what does he do? He just throws this good fastball right by, brings the express. No chance to put that ball in play.
So now to the plate, Jose Altuve. Fastball. hits the zone for a strike.
1-2.
Lifted in the air to right field. Kepler's on the move. He makes the running play. 2 down. And that'll bring up the former first rounder, Alex Bregman. And they're down to their final four outs here, Dan.
Yeah, it's not looking too good for them right now, Matt. They've got a significant hill to climb, but they've got to take it one bat at a time. A couple of guys get on, and then who knows what could happen.
The 1-1 home. Is swung on and driven out to right center field. A ball that's well hit. Center fielder on the run. Gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. 1-2-3 go the Astros. They still trail here. It's 6-2. Nolan Paredes enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. New inning set to get underway, and now it'll be the catcher, Ryan Jeffers. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Down the left field line and deep, but this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game.
That's the third time in this game he's gone down on strikes. Not the game he was hoping to have when he was taking batting practice, but at least his guys are ahead.
To the plate now, Andrelton Simmons. Swing and a high chopper. And that's the second out.
Now batting.
So the batting order turns over now and set to go Max Kepler. And looking to improve on a 1-for-5 effort so far. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. 2 out, nobody on. And he fouls this one off. He'll try again. 1-2.
Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to go a little bit further outside the zone. 3 foul balls in a row. He wants to get a swing and a miss on this next pitch.
And they come inside with the fastball, but it misses here, and it's back to 2-2.
I don't blame the pitcher one bit for trying to get to chase right there. He's been fouling everything off. He's still
swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Down go the Twins in order. They lead it 6-2. Taylor Rogers is on, and he'll take over on the mound in relief.
For Minnesota, number 55. Taylor.
Now to the plate, Michael Brantley. He's the one to start off the ninth inning with his guys in danger of going down 2-0 if they can't rally. The 2-1. Swing and a line drive. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning.
Guys, that jacks me up right there. Kept his front shoulder tough, the hip tough. Was able to stay inside that slider and drive it the other way.
Oh, into the box now. Carlos Correa.
A bouncer to the left side.
Simmons on to first, and that's the very last thing they needed at this point in the ball game, as there are quickly two away now.
Oh, man, that's just a backbreaker right there. Get the leadoff man to start the ninth, and they're looking pretty good, right? Not when the next guy bounces into a double play. We'll see if they can get the final out and wrap this thing up.
In now, Yordan Alvarez.
Bouncer to the left side,
and that's in for a base hit. He's two for four now.
Sometimes you just got to tip your hat to the offense right there. Nice
the
piece of hitting. Executed
10.
His pitch away again,
Julius,
but the hitter was able to stay on time.
Stepping in now, Yuli Gurriel. And this is swung on and missed. So now they find themselves down to their final strike tonight. Jay Happ would be in line for the victory should the score hold. Last strike now for Houston. And that misses two and two.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Swing and a liner. Buxton is there to make the catch, and with that, the ball game is over.
You might think it's just another win, but it's awfully hard to win in this game, especially on the road. But they find it done, and they should be very happy with this performance.
And tonight's ends at a 6-2 finish. Minnesota get the win to take a 2-0 series lead. Jay Happ takes home the win. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.